So I love Jojo's bizarre adventures, and one of the things that makes Jojo unique in comparison to other manga is Araki's decision to incorporate influences from high fashion and modeling into his art. Now, this has led some to see Jojo as quote-unquote gay or having homoerotic undertones, which is a valid opinion, and Araki knows this and totally plays into it in the manga. I prefer to call Araki's aesthetic feminine-masculine juxtaposition, but I understand why people refer to it as gay. But then I started to think, I mean, is Jojo actually gay? Are any of the Jojos queer? Or, scratch it, not just the main characters, are there any queer characters in Jojo at all? Now, in this analysis, I'm going to be focusing on the first five parts of Jojo, as that's what's available in anime format, but also because I want to keep the story focused on male queerness. So, sorry, Jolene and the lesbian crew, and sorry, Scarlet Valentine. We'll talk about you another time. So, with that said, let's get started. Is she gay or European? Gay or European? Gay or Europe? Wait a minute. I'm going to try my best to not speculate. I'm gonna take what information we have and extrapolate what that means about each Jojo's sexuality. I want to acknowledge that, of course, it's possible that these characters might have had crushes or relationships that we didn't see on page or on screen. But let's just say that if we didn't see it, it didn't happen. Let's go in order and start with the first Jojo, our good boy Jonathan. From what we see, we only see Jonathan attracted to one person, and that's Irina. Very simple, Jonathan is straight. Joseph is often shipped with Shiza-chan.
Very nice, Shiza-chan!
And I honestly love this ship. But in reality, there's no evidence to suggest that they ever had romantic or sexual feelings towards one another. Joseph does end up marrying Suzy Q. He also has an affair with Tomoko Higashikata as an older man. I'd say that Joseph is straight. Unlike his predecessors, Jotaro isn't given a romantic interest in his part of the story. We see that Jotaro is indifferent to, if not slightly annoyed by women, but I mean, I think he feels that way about most humans, male and female. If all we knew about Jotaro was him in part 3, I would say it's hard to tell what his sexuality is, and I might potentially say that he could be Aero Ace. But Jotaro's story continues past part 3, and in part 6 we learn that Jotaro had a wife and had a daughter. So let's say that he's straight. Josuke also doesn't get a romantic interest and isn't shown to be particularly interested in any girls. But he does tell us that he's a believer in true love, so he probably isn't aromantic. Some people think that Okuyasu and Josuke are gay for each other, and I'm totally down for people supporting that ship. But in reality, there's no explicit clue of them having a sexual or romantic relationship, so I'm gonna put Josuke as undecided. Giorno also doesn't have a romantic interest in the story. Araki does pair him with Mista a number of times. One particular scenario was an innocent scene of Giorno healing Mista, but it was misinterpreted by Narancia as a sexual moment. But hey, Narancia was awesome. He just pretended not to see anything and he never ever brought it up. I mean, what a great bro. I do think that Araki likes the idea of pairing Mista and Giorno. Whether that's simply for aesthetics or maybe they're contrasting personalities, it's hard to say. Although they are paired frequently, we don't get any clues that either one of them think that their interactions are romantic or sexual. So again, I think I'm gonna have to put him in the, I don't know, undecided category. So okay, we've established that none of the Jojos are explicitly queer. They definitely could be interpreted to be queer characters, but we have no definitive proof. And to be honest, I'm okay with that. And I actually like that none of the Jojos are gay. If Giorno or Josuke are revealed to be queer in the future, I'd be pretty stoked. But only if it makes sense in the story, I don't want it to be forced. Because here's the thing, why is it that Jojo is called gay even when none of them actually are? Well, let's have a quick little discussion about toxic masculinity. It's an idea that masculinity is defined by an appearance of toughness. That means suppressing your emotions, and also proving your strength through acts of violence. These quote-unquote traditional ideas of masculinity can be harmful to society, but also to men themselves, who are unable to explore what it means to be a male outside of this mold. In other words, someone with a toxic masculine ideology would have a hard time understanding and accepting that a man can care so much about his hair and love the designer shoes and still be a man. That a man can fully explore his emotions and cry and still be a man. That a man can be an expert in healing and nurturing more than harming and still be a man. Unless, of course, maybe you're not a traditional man. When a man breaks away from the traditional mold of masculinity, the easiest explanation is that there must be something different about him. And the answer is that he must not be straight. He must be queer, because real men are only attracted to women. Now, I want to mention there's nothing wrong with people thinking that you're gay, and queer men have been groundbreaking in shattering gender norms and expectations, and I don't want to take that away from the queer culture, but I think to label the Jojos who don't fit into the traditional mold of masculinity as queer reinforces the idea that straight men cannot like fashion, that straight men can't show their emotions and can't be fabulous and sexy and show their midriff. I totally understand if, for you, it's more powerful to assume that the Jojos are queer and for them to be a symbol of queer masculinity. And again, I cannot emphasize enough what an impact queer culture has had on blurring the lines of masculine and feminine expression. But I personally think it's more powerful for a bulky, masculine, straight guy to dress like this and pose like this. I think the Jojos are great role models for straight boys who get to see a strong and masculine man embrace and accept his feminine side. On the contrary, I think it'd be great to see a queer Jojo who actually acts very traditionally masculine. Jotaro would have been a great candidate for that. Between the two undecided Jojos, I think it'd be awesome to have Giorno potentially be developed as a queer character. He's pretty reserved in showing his emotions and is the don of the mafia organization So despite his bright pink outfit, he actually fits the traditional masculine mold quite well. And I mean, a gay Italian gangster. Come on, like that'd be so cool. I think he and Mista had great chemistry and it'd be interesting to explore a potential relationship between the two. And I think this would be a good move for Araki. Araki has written in a few canonically queer characters. However, interestingly, the majority of them are antagonists. Part 5 featured two queer couples, Sorbet and Gelato, two members of La Squadra, and Tiziano and Squalo. None of these characters are recurring characters. Sorbet and Gelato, we only really learn about them through flashbacks, and Tiziano and Squalo were only featured in 2 episodes. So yeah, I mean, Araki gets points for having queer characters, but none of them were fully developed characters. One very prominent character in the JoJo franchise that is queer is Dio. In part 6, we see some flashbacks that shows us that Dio has had relationships with women as well as with men. So Dio is canonically bisexual, and I love that. But, this doesn't change the fact that all of these characters are antagonists, and none of them perpetuate terrible stereotypes of queer people, but as I mentioned in my video on bisexual villainesses in the Bat Universe, there's still a subconscious association of queerness and immorality. So for the only queers in the universe to be bad guys is not a great move. And the best way to counter this isn't to make these villains straight, it's to add more queer protagonists. As much as I love my straight fabulous Jojo boys, maybe it's time for Araki to introduce a queer protagonist. What do you guys think? I would love to know your thoughts.